Rwycwch James Connolly Johnston neu lama yeddig yn y tŵlting daich y tycedd. Srach y gael ddwrdd gys cwch byn y hewrbys y chwyl y dŵr sy'n fydd chorym yn y bol cosyn a halab achosnig. Lwch fwn y strachin y glach mach menem na mynd yn y dŵcha. Y fydd yn bel glach ag yn da chwych le halamp sy'n y laic sy'ch yn y fan yn adar. Bechinki yn ffaren yma fydd ach na gachu chagaredd ach dad. Cela, ad ag y sienedd. Ferig af sound ydy fi beo, mae'r chlychydas mae'r gynnu.
He could hold a tune, but sometimes it was, he'd tell a wee bit too long, you know. You're like, oh God, mate.
He would be kicking the ball. If he was watching the telly, he'd be up shouting, kicking the ball, heading it.
He was a hard taskmaster. When I was younger, like train. He used to wear a wee bin bag underneath, and that's all you could hear. He's at the back, he's like, shh, shh, running. Come on, sir.
I always say, wee's dad, I lived with him and fun him out then, wouldn't I? If I wouldn't have married him, eh? I'd have ran away.
Ha un rwyd a Cris Gialach Eundach Jimmy Johnston. Dachy.
The place that I was born and bred in, View Park, Hornington, I've got to talk about that because it's a dear to me. You made your bows and arrows and you built your dens, you climbed the trees. And in general, it was just one big happy time I can remember in my childhood.
Fai cwtioch y clychiau Balcosia, fat and jewel.
This is him for 8 o'clock in the morning, maybe before it. He's out. Dawn to dusk. With a sweet tanner ball. 10 movements, controlling it. That was him.
Chai ym mian siws o'n bal cosio go I ddele, nyr ychai ag yn sgol.
When he was 5 years of age, he entered the school and said to the headmistress, when do I get into the team? I mean, that was his first comment. She told me that, I interviewed her. That was his very first, when did I get into the school team? And that gave you an idea of his ambition, perky, no respect whatsoever for this dominant figure of headmistress and so on. And then she looked out of a window and saw him playing in the playground and realized he wasn't kidding.
Chara Jimmy Fadder cost the clues and skipping a scholar. Chara on chewlach juge and a fi gwtaichrish.
I played for St Augustine's Primary in Coatbridge, and Jimmy was played for St Columba's in View Park. And we played them in a cup final in St Mary's Park in Whifflet. And 1-3-1. I scored the 3 goals. I was tall in those days compared to Jimmy, who was like a small elf, if you like. And after the game, Jimmy's mummy and the women from View Park felt that there's no way that I was under 12, so they attacked me with umbrellas and hit me and battered me, and I had to run shouting for, sir, sir, these women are attacking me. So it was quite funny after, but it wasn't funny at the time.
I played in Chapel Hall, the other one of the schools and that, and he played in the View Park school, was Ernison, and he always heard his name getting mentioned, that, you know.
Fews ag yn nŵs o'ch sio fa ffys ag y tjefa ag i'r i gianw.
He went in one day and he says, I'll tell you what I'll do with you. I'm going to become a right professional football player. I says, is that right? Yes, he says, that's right. He says, I know I've got it to make it. And he says, right then, fair enough, we'll get a buzz. And he did.
The school, I remember, used to get in the morning, 8:30 in the morning. St Columba's View Park. And used to put the jackets down then, picked the sides. And that was you. The bell went at 9 o'clock, you were in. 10 o'clock, you eat your break, you were back out again. You did the sides, the same score, the sides or whatever, you start it again. Then, when you were finished your dinner, you were right out into the playground, and the game kept going again. And everything was all revolved all around about football.
Vrosnich looked check as Jimmy, a host Haaland, and his hoochie-kitek as his skill in Nantara Kiglesig.
He had that something that I could see that he was the best person I had ever seen playing football.
We had this mop, he'd mop a curly hair. He was all right, dressed. Wasn't his jeans or nothing like that. He always, you know, had kind of suits and that on. But he'd always had thick red hair, dead curly and everything.
Just small ginger, you know what I mean? My mum was always that bit taller than me and stuff. But I just always remember being a really fit man, you know, really.
Fa falaniach y cilwch y crwys cwtioch, rwyd eich llech gyda yno i ffwn i fan as mwy yna.
When somebody was trying to nail me, that's when you knew you had them. You know, that was all the encouragement you needed. You just, you would get it and say, right, give us it again. You'd go to them, then take it into the box and let them kick them all, you know, kick you all you want.
It amazed me just how small I was, considering I was just a pretty young and small kid myself. And I remember sitting on the wall, you know, just in the periphery of the jungle and the ball coming off the park, and I got up and I think I was only about 9 or 10 and I kicked it and it only moved about a foot, and Jimmy came over and actually picked the ball up and ruffled my hair and I nearly fainted. But I couldn't believe how small I was.
He was a brave wee guy, you know. He wouldn't lie down at the end, you know.
Oh, this is brilliant stuff from Johnston.
I think Agnes was the only one that could knock him out, you know.
Diagnosis, it was just he thought his hands were sore, you know, and it was one day he couldn't pick, we went to pick the kettle up, we couldn't pick the kettle up, and he's like, there's something's wrong here.
He felt his wrists weak. We'd never have known anything.
So you would see him just going like that, with his fingers just kind of, and you would see the feeling. I mean, I think it was Big Roddy that caught it for him.
Roddy McDonald phoned me that Jimmy had went to him if he was losing the feeling in the end of his fingers, and Roddy was excellent.
Wolf the Evan Irishell on the Kyers Nach Vogh had good Jimmy Dia with Jürgen Kwas Haneke.
Jimmy Seiden and I rocked him right over the fence. He was in Old Edinburgh Road, 647, and I'm in 3 Simrise Avenue. So all I did was jump over the fence, and that was in each other's houses. For that size, to the now.
My father, Matt, was a miner. My ma, Sarah, were just ordinary working class people. You know, didn't have a lot.
Get the van mochtel as a howlach, charais an aadha lentil shears gan as lichuel.
Father came in for work and got this tin bath, right where he got washed. That was it. And he says, that's not for me, I'll never do that.
Hi Jimmy, you hook on the chill of his for gulach, a fat dun and guy in hain and a jipper shorts a scrapping.
He was the youngest of five. His oldest brother, Pat, went away down to Doncaster really young. And then his three sisters, Annie, Mary, and Teresa, they were really quiet lassies. So they were. But Jimmy, I think he made up for the five of them when he was a wee boy. So he was. Always getting into bother. He got caught at everything he was doing when he was a wee boy, but that was him.
So the signs were already there?
That's it. Oh, Torag.
Be mi orstans cha be mi fwg y hwg gwaedden yn polisau se siwl gachu i'r faes y gylchlyni efo party a stiwyd y Billy Jules Lifters ga.
I said, you want a game? I said, right. See that bike there? This is under a stairwell. Now, it's a wee weenie, maybe 4 or 5 year old. They're the size of the bike, right? They're your transport. Away and jump that and get him. So the next thing is, his knees is up, and his chin mate, when it's wee bit, I'll tell you, right? Next minute, he's pulled, pull us. Blue Riker's on. Jimmy, you're pulled.
He'd creach at a dhuil ach maddy gúil as cáil, spi cáil hú cáram sudaíat at Jimmy at Agnes Doherty at a chlub ócri.
He used to bring his wee record player and we played to that, and then next thing we'd a wee group. So we had, it was his record players, but I think we depended on him on a Friday night to bring his records. We had a good time, so we had good fun.
Ach ar a urydd dwi gael y gân, nyr ychynig Jimmy ddim mad Agnes.
My mammy thought he was a role boy. And he was coming to the door, he had a new poplin coat on. So she says, go and pay that wee role boy, Agnes. I says, Mum, that's my boyfriend. She says, what is he not off you, wee? I says, Mum, we're going to the pictures and that today. So he comes in. I think his eyes were mesmerised by the brothers and all the family and everything, you know, the big family. But it's the noise and racket was going on in our house, and his house was really quiet.
Edda Fath give a Jimmy at all the nurse good nurse. If Coors call of the St John's Guild, the Toshach Nishiskitan, noch goo the Manchester United, a fa heat goo na Pashka the Gachi.
I've been doing to Manchester, this boys' club in Manchester, and we played them. It was an annual thing we used to have, and my brother was at a match, and there was a scout there, Man United scout, and he came up to me, funnily, he asked my brother who I was. And my brother had the clippings and all that, and the pocket, they proceeded to tell him, and they were going to sign me. And it's John Higgins found out about it, and John went to the Celtic, and the Celtic signed me in a provisional.
Chaiach ur amach, a skipper juniors blantyre Celtic. And sin, glachga ada and luchtaid nashinta, agus chlicha game sorry just on skipper juniors na halapa a nua yeading an a trifika cigar. Glachga kuchach ada na mianyan. Celtic's provisionally booked teenage winger Jim Johnston of Blantyre Celtic will be a top senior personality in 2 years' time. Nicknamed Di Stefano by his pals, he can kill the ball with either foot and pass it with the same golden touch as the Real Madrid idol.
Jimmy could be quite irritating if you were playing against him, because he would beat you and then come back and beat you again and then come back and beat you again, and didn't make him very popular, you know. So in the juniors, I think that would help him, because there would be players there that wouldn't like that at all and would let him know.
They were hard, hard games that you played, you know. I mean, you would get them coming. If you took the ball by him here, you would come here, do that again. And they're like, when you're a boy at 17, 18, build that.
Oh, absolutely.
You know? What do you do, you know?
Skoleitach I chrua, iach cae meilad a dhliach an a bolach.
Oh, aye, he was determined to be, you know, play for Celtic, and that was him, just his dream.
McNamee taking the throw to Murdoch.
Cleach Jimmy here at Yemek is in Celtic and now Kilavarnock, Savars, Trifigas a three. The Avian situation for La Moore Elith father, a Hiat Horse Yerenach, the New Rangers.
I saw this wee figure, diminutive figure, running onto the pitch in a green white shirt. And at first I thought it was a wee ball boy that surreptitiously had picked up the Celtic strip and gone on to greet his heroes. I did think it was a part of an invasion. I couldn't believe it. Tiny wee red haired, carroty. Haired character. And of course, at that stage, Rangers were strong favourites because of their very settled team.
I said, in a man you can never ignore, Johnson coming in.
To be through in Hampden, maybe, you know, 100,000 plus crowd and against the Rangers, especially, it's not something you really look forward to.
He's up against it here because it was a dreich day. It was wet, the pitch was very muddy. It churned up very quickly and so on. And yet, he skidded over it, he pirouetted, he turned, he twisted.
Johnson. Trovan towering above him. Now you see why Celtic decided to play this little boy today.
You get through it, and I know we did get through it. Didn't he play well, and I didn't play well. And I think we drew one each. And then the following game, I think I got dropped for Bobby Craig. And then again, they beat us 3-0, so...
I don't know, I think I come off not too bad, you know.
Get the knock again, dras the ears to hear skipper. The bank is the heel jock steen, Celtic and a drifik is a coach. A hoshik jinky, a racha kunaval of Kostnig, not far as hain.
Steen went to a reserve game that he wouldn't normally have gone to at that stage. In fact, Steen himself said to me, I just went because there were two Brazilians playing, but we're going to have a look at. Instead, he saw Jimmy.
He came in, stood aside me, says, never forget it. What are you doing playing here? I mean, words, you know, were magic to me. He says, you should be in that first team, he says. I went out and scored a hat try. I never done it in my life again.
And at the end of the game, Steen said, I want you.
That's what Jock Steen was magnificent at, was motivating people. He just knew just where to tweak, where to touch, what to say.
And Jimmy ran out to the car park, some of the friends waiting for him, he says, they're keeping me, they're keeping me.
Has Pars Junior, but Jimmy, you can see a huge man at high. Can the fair of you click your corner to Celtic?
He worked in Finlay's. Yeah, that's when he met Tommy Gamel.
Used to play football in the playground at Burnbank Technical College. And I'm not kidding you, you couldn't get the ball off Jinky. It was impossible to get the ball off him. And I mean, we're saying to ourselves, who is this guy? And then before I know it, I was at Celtic Park along with him. incredible.
But Jimmy Kuchuk could glach gather a chuchlichet then, but Galina co-ferpic rogue of a shona misk.
I seen this wee ball, wee kind of red-headed boy. Nae hair, just red-headed, you know. And it was all curly. And I says, here, come on, what are we doing with ball boys in training, you know? And this wee lad with the ball, and I didn't think he was going to give us it back. And we were mystified and, oh God, but he had talent. That's, he had talent.
And we're training the concourse, and this wee red-headed guy came up and joined in, and I'm thinking, is this guy up his daddy's piece or something? Or is he, what's he joining in for? Because I never heard him, I never knew him. And that was my first ever seen with Jimmy. It was really strange. Then all of a sudden we went training down the pitch later, a couple of nights later, and I knew why he was here.
But up with Chrua, you clear pairs of Jimmy. Do you know anything in the Vicha Massa Puringa?
He was a grafter at training. One thing is for sure, he never slacked. He was one of the hardest, if not the hardest, trainers at Celtic Park at that time.
Had a training avish gillior as St Jimmy. Ye mega hain a fuchtig fat a jewel.
After training or in the house, he always done sit ups, press ups, and have a medicine ball, and he would get us to drop it on his stomach and think, and then go and punch me hard, you know, to like involve us in his sort of training. So he was always very active and keep myself fit. Tried to get us to go out training and stuff with him as well when we were like maybe kind of lazy teenagers, that sort of thing. But he was always proactive that way, yeah, definitely.
Well, me and my dad, we used to go to Wooddean all the time, and we used to play football. And these boys, I used to go to school with them, and we used to try and kick them, boot them. And this was later on, you couldn't get the ball off them.
We used to get the called the green bus. It was an Edinburgh bus that came from Edinburgh.
The bus stop was right across from Jimmy's house.
I got to know the driver, so if I was running a wee bit late with the worker or whatever, he would wait on when you took the horn, you know.
The conductor says, when Jimmy Johnson comes on, the bus moves, you know, and all you see is 10 minutes later, wee jinky walking out in a big mop of hair and that, you know. But he never spoke to him, but he'd just walk in and sit in the bus, and then the driver would shout out, that's us now, we'll continue our journey into Glasgow, you know.
Le Leichshin allowing a fast nas missa, how Jimmy gadoch the Celtic Roddy Donaloch and the Davila Sahoon.
Roddy kind of knew straight away that it was serious, and he took him to see a specialist. And they'd brought Jimmy in and he'd told him. and Jimmy had said to him, look, I want you to tell Willie. I didn't understand what MND was, you know, and I was kind of a wee bit all over the place. I couldn't take it in at first. But then when the reality sank in, I was devastated. And I kept thinking about, wow, what's he thinking?
Jimmy was such in a state saying he was calling this wee doctor for everything because he's this wheelchair carry on, he just couldn't handle that. But Roddy was explaining to me what would happen shortly.
Bydd bwylio chrwy i fan gaffain y mach gyda o'n chynnys marafdioch motor niwrynydd sy'n thosioch fa sy'n anleach y chlefon y chlawn.
Don't tell the wains, but my mum's going to have to.
My mum says to us, took him down, and then she tells us, and then a wee bit devastated through it all.
I remember coming in and my mum saying, look, and saying, Dad's got motor neuron disease, and it was like, it's kind of disbelief, you know, at the time, you're like, what? She says, I've got something to tell you. Excuse me. And she says, it's my dad. My dad was in motor neuron. I can't believe it.
Gennyn gyro'r chlw y sîr gael y med, chad y hawch joc stîn jinkies yn cwr sîr ynach, cwch byn hanaf yn oed yn ffarlang yn y difficult y cwr.
How can you drop Jimmy Jones? It's just a nonsense.
I was shattered. I remember what he was doing at Largs when he announced the team. And Jock, as you know, he was with Dunfermline. And I think he knew the inside to the Dunfermline defence. So I think he had this made up in his mind. This is how that he was going to win this match. And he did win it at the end of the day.
Number six to Chemers. An intelligent pass. Chemers with McLean.
A bydd ffadau gysyb eich bwy'n gylio'r yn poch y Jimmy Cata, chydau dwys yn siechdol ddi bawn cwchb y lig a'n adrifig y sysia, le tewl y nwyd yn ffarlain gan cwtiwch eich yn y chrwnd. Fa'n Cartus ac Jimmy ddi Jock Steen ac cli yn seddaf ych ys achosiniag Celtic.
The gaffer loved him, but he was easy to love, you know, he was just, he was what you call a cheeky chappy. He would do things maybe he shouldn't have done, but he'd come back and be all smiles and all laughing and just him, you know. The gaffer loved him. The gaffer helped him out a lot in his career, I think, you know. He was good for him.
He loved him like a son. You know, he was probably the only player, I think I'm safe in saying, in the dressing room that he would regard almost as family. Sometimes troublesome part of that family, but nevertheless family.
Bydd dyn nhw'n tain sy'n fan y stîn, ac ys fe Jew Isaac Jimmy na'ch bwyrin gael bra gael y ddechartus y feithra.
Keep doing, you couldn't get close to him. I must say that. He always thought you were, but he always kept your arms lean. Which is right. You know, I mean, maybe it meant you felt that maybe he owed something or whatever, but he could always just, at that, he would shy off. He'd go so far. It was the same with everybody.
Joey here ticht the leg hook steen the skipper course could canatua america aus bermuda heel jimmy gachita a force agnes I guess it in the ash and he crag of the flane with a cockle of clear
that flight your pocket he says he'll never forget that as long as he lives. They were all at meals, the kids were floating and meals were floating, air hostesses were throwing about. He says just dive down and he says right back up he came.
That really put me absolutely, totally off.
Go back to get married to me, too. He'd be wishing he stayed in America.
Everybody knows that he didn't like flying, so we're going to Las Vegas for the Celtic convention. And I said, no, you need to come. He says, right, OK, I'm coming. So we got on the plane. And we're on the plane and I'm sitting like this, you know, this, and I see him. I said, what are you doing? And he's got a wee plastic bottle in his hand and he's spraying it on the plane. He said, what are you doing? Holy water. Got some holy water out of chops.
I was like, you guys put off the plane. He sprayed the plane with holy water.
My father died in November 2001. Died on the 17th of November. He was buried about 10 days later. Bertie Old went to pick up Jimmy. And there's a driveway going down to Lourdes, and as he parked the car in the driveway...
And that's when they broke the news to me. And it was so serious. And I was in the driving seat. He says, Bert, he says, I've just been diagnosed with motor neuron. Oh, I says, Junkie. I thought you were a Mercedes man. He says, see, you're a bad guy. He says, can you never be serious? I'd never heard what motor neuron was. You know, man, but as time went on, then I realised what motor neuron was.
He phoned me to say he had this disease and it was absolutely horrendous.
When you heard it was what it was, you know, it was a kind of shattering feeling for a wee while.
Well, it was a terrible shock that Jimmy was struck down with this horrible illness.
Chwych Jimmy, jyddoch ti yr eich tŵrys ys yn alapa, a charwai ddi e ffat efo adyn y mian yn colodd ys ysgip yn las ynta. Gysor eich yn y siach gyd sy'n cedd, fe nad eich afa adach ys gyr trwag na charwai ffwyddoch y chydd.
No, to be honest, it was just the boys a night out. That was basically what it was. We were down there for a fortnight, and me Willie Orman, who was a great wee guy as well, just says to us, look, when you go out, we had a right good time, we had a few drinks, and coming back, we were in the side of the, what do you call it, the shore. And just for some unknown reason, I thought Sandy Jarden was with maybe Dennis, Billy, and I went, right, turned to his boat. I said, right, we fancy going out, you know, stupid. You know, come on, we'll go just jump out. And I jumped in the boat and Sandy shoved it out.
I said, you didn't push it far enough, Sandy. Aye. Causing commotions that night again, eh? Telling you.
Dan Carter said Jimmy that she skipped a nation to die with the verrute in Tullich.
Jimmy was sometimes dropped in favour of Willie Henderson for Rangers, who was actually a very talented player in his own right. And of course, up here, if you're playing for Scotland and you're a Celtic player, the Rangers support saying we've got a better plane, you know, so on and so forth. You know. So there was always that kind of element against it.
He didn't get the support, I didn't feel that. You should have got when you were playing for your country. You thought when you were your country, everybody's behind you, but it didn't happen.
Maybe significant that the two most dangerous and top players were the respective right wingers, Johnson and Henderson. See what they can do in the second half.
Far na pathia chai Cardison Marinach and Tokal Gita.
See, they two, honestly, they were a great act. They were the two Ronnies. They had everything. You know, the two of them, great players, magnificent players. But the great thing about the two of them were they're humorous, they're approachable, they were a great advert for each club. Honestly, they were tremendous.
You know, the friendship was just sheer admiration for each other. You know, it wasn't a friendship where we were out regularly together. You know, I mean, certainly there was times we would maybe go out and have a cup of tea and a shandy and enjoy it, you know, but the respect and the admiration was a big part of the sort of friendship.
Er tyfystau squad Celtic, banodd cost y sirach gar y fath daif yn ydyn grwychu.
We used to go and prepare, which was a tremendous thing, doing it Seamall. We used to go there for every European match, which was a must, and the guys loved it because the adrenaline started being, you know, when you were coming up in that bus coming up, and then you were coming up and you come up the London Road there and turning into the park. And then we used to get a Celtic song as we're coming up the last couple of hundred yards there, you know, just great because you seen all the people and you're around the bus and whatnot, and that's when it did, that's when it hurt you. But all these wee things mattered. They were awfully important at that in that time.
He loved, that was his favourite place. He loved seeing me. He loved walking along the shore and he loved getting the ball out down there. And when he went down there, everything he could do right, he did right down at Seamall. He just loved being there. Love the build-up for the big games.
You can't tell any stories about down there. Maybe a lot of folk maybe hear them off record and that, but...
Bych Bobby Lennox is jinky sy'n nŵ rŵm ag si mil ag is fad yn ochr yn corym a fel ag atyn yn ffynergaeth.
So we put these water pistols back to the hotel, up into the room, fought them up, goes down to the dining room, doesn't say anything.
Remember we came in, we're all sitting orderly for a dinner and all of a sudden, the two idiots with the water guns, remember? Boom, boom. So we all went out, we planned, we went out that afternoon. Good. I think you had a big machine gun thing, Chola.
I think it was that big one.
We all waited till the two walked in.
We're all running about shooting water pistols all over the place. I mean, daft things, but the things that made us, you know, the things that made the Lisbon Lions was things like that, hundreds of things like that, practical joking.
Van Carter said that Bobby is Jimmy, the guy in a chile should know you back in the cowl, lipic and kuchach of a garage.
I think the Beatles are about to do with that, you know, he loved the music, loved singing and I loved the music, so we got on great, right from the start we got on great, you know, just two guys that got up together and enjoyed each other's company.
Can you find that Jimmy a geish at the kill that could shine at the kutcher and the call on cue?
Jimmy lived across the road from where we practiced or rehearsed grounds in the dressing room of Thornwood United Football Club in View Park. Jimmy decided he'd come over because he'd always fancied himself as a bit of a singer and he'd come and join in rehearsals and difficult getting him off the mic at times, but that was it.
Used to sing to me, "You're once, twice, three times a lady." I used to say, "Down that road." Used to tell me, "Get home and everything." Once, twice, three times, he tried to keep in with me. But he sung anything. So he had a nightmare.
He was a great singer. My dad, he said if he wasn't a footballer, he wanted to be a singer. And Rod Stewart wanted to be a footballer. He said, I always remember him, his music on, and influenced me in a lot of my music that I still listen to.
Bleanach yn y stiwysyn fe jinky iddo goi glan o'r un y hein coddi Jim Kerr y son Caranus.
I think a dream come true, I think, for him. We were kidding him on saying, you're going to be on top of the box, and he's like, I'll be right. But he enjoyed the song. It was great to come in. If you walked in and you caught him singing in the mirror and things like that. But somebody made the mistake, one of us made the mistake of buying him at the time, so you'll know how long ago it was a VHS, a music video. On Bon Jovi, so unfortunately when he had a few shandies, he would come in. No, he'd come in and we used to hide it. Used to hide the video. Where's that video? Because he'd have it up, oh God. Bed of Roses and oh, John Bon Jovi. So. Bed of Roses.
Masker oes sy'n berle Jimmy a chasen o'ch ymwyl y talw trochydd. Fad eich listi gybrein plen, rwyt eich lech Steen gybwyn o'ch Celtic yn y gem yn ymwyl yn o'r Red Star Belgrade.
Steen was very good at creating myths. And the story went about that at half-time he went into the toilet, stood beside Jimmy and said, if you do well in this second half, you don't need to fly. So this was an inducement. You don't need to fly to Red Star Belgrade. Well, he went out and played Merry Hell with Red Star. He was brilliant and so on. He was even back in his own penalty area defending. Billy McNeil said to him, what the hell are you doing here? He was so desperate to please. And of course, afterwards, this came out in the press. But it was a myth, because 3 days before the game, Roger Bailey had written the column with Jock Steen saying, I'll let Jimmy off flying to Belgrade if he plays well the other night. This is three days before the game. So it was nothing to do at half-time and so on. And Jimmy responded to that myth. He just kept it going, of course.
Ban clisiw hwyth Jimmy na hwyl ych anelydd, cwadig ar iddyf y fach yn ochs y charter sio.
The following day, he got hold of me, he says, look, the coach came to me after, he says, look, you've got to get the people a red star or Belgrade, let them see Jimmy Johnston. I said, no chance. You promised me.
He could produce games like Red Star that nobody else could have. You know, he had that kind of special talent to do that, and that's just the way it was.
Car a tuff hawl yn y hun lach yn y chlechgig a sy'n plenig yn y hechnig, mae'r hwyd ac nes ymach ydd chwrs y Sbaen.
Remember that game though? Right after Agnes flew it to Madrid. They were going home. To be Manchester. I'm no flying. I'm no flying. How are you going to get a bearing on me? She's up to a taxi. You might just stand the street in Madrid, see if you can get a taxi to Benidorm. Oh, did you order it? That was clever. Must have been Agnes who'd done that.
That passage room, the door opened, and the two of them appeared, and he took cases, and I said, Jimmy, I'll help you with that. So I took him downstairs, and he said, shitty old to everybody, and we went outside, and the concierge called a taxi, and I gave Agnes a kiss and got in the back of the car, and Jimmy got in as well. I said, I'll see you, Kearney. He says, I'll see you pre-season training. I said, all the best, you man, have a great time. And he turned to the taxi driver and he said, Benidorm. Now, it's not exactly around the corner, you know. And the guy put it in the gear and then turned round and said, Benidorm.
I couldn't walk when I got out the motor, we ran it that long. And the back door was tied up with string. And the wee man was driving round the Pyrenees, he was fleeing round them. And he was sitting in the middle of that Jimmy man, because every time we were going, I was leaning in topium, he was saying, don't lean over here, he says, because that string's in this story, mind you, his side, right?
Must have taken about 8 hours. He could have gotten down the plane in an hour. He took the taxi down or something, you know. But that was Jimmy, you know, and you miss all that, you know. Nothing like that happens anymore, you know. A bit of fun here and there.
Up to Johnson. Johnson gives the impression of thoroughly enjoying this. Sock round the ankle.
But Agnes is Jimmy and the Madrid called the Celtics on game 2 of Di Stefano. Gagnon van Laar, the show game of bear of Fleece Jimmy Veer.
That was the side, Real Madrid. We never a class act. And we literally did, we tore them apart right through the team. And we get a standing ovation at the end of it, myself personally, because I played with my skin that night.
In the Bernabeu Stadium, one man, Jinky. They stood and they applauded, they must have applauded 10 minutes.
Murdered the left back. And at one point near the end of the game, he went towards him with the ball and he waved him in. And the guy just went like that. Yeah. Chucked it. I'd had enough, you know. And he beat him every way he could possibly beat somebody.
It was a case of just giving Jimmy the ball, you know. I would say that is one of the best displays I've ever seen. You know, it was really tremendous.
Di Stefano didn't know what had hit him. As soon as wee Jinky got the ball, all he could hear was, ole, ole, ole. He was up to defenders and going past them as if he was a bullfighter.
He was absolutely brilliant that night. He did everything he could do and he finished the game holding the ball up.
Bekan Vlierenich in a Stewish in Vanu skilled the Aichkin and the Gaka Leeds United and the Snummerman to near Kurshirinach the Hoop in the Kjörfer.
Terry Cooper was left back at times, young left back. Well, Jimmy. He turned him inside out and outside in. I don't think the guy knew where he was.
Oh, Terry, I know. But the game was due, though. He never once turned to the dirties, you know. He played his fair, because Terry was a footballer.
Without a doubt, I've never seen anybody play like that. It was just unbelievable, unplayable.
The final of the European Cup for the second time. Balan Gu, like Jimmy and Gerard Nersch, and a Chlechke, because in Granchi and with a genius motor neuron.
His determination that he showed on the pitch, you know, if you can multiply that by 10, that's how determined he was to find a cure for M&D. I mean, like, it was bordering on insanity. Like, you know, he would come to my place one day and say, we're going to Africa, there's a guy here, got this snake milk that they can inject into you. And I'm like, whoa, no, we're not doing that, Jimmy. And he was full of false hope.
But this time, not about done, he had decided, all right,
I might not know the ins and outs, but I'll get to know folk that does. Ian Wilmot, who'd cloned Dolly the sheep, I thought, surely no, with visions of Jimmy coming home with cloven hoofs on him, etc. No, he insisted Ian Wilmot's the man for me. I thought, oh my God, two jinkies running about. But he was really into the science of it.
Try it on me. That's how brave he was. That's how he'd say, try it on me. If you've got a drug, try it on me. But he was too big a man, too big a personality for him to take chances if anything happened to him, you know what I mean?
He was desperate to beat it, desperate. But that catches up nobody, that thing.
When he got told he was getting the motor neuron, he thought, I'm going to get better, I'm going to, you know, because now he had that weakening nature in him.
He fought through it all, he really did. He was really, really brave. And he'd say sometimes, I'm really fed up, you know, but you just have to give him a wee, try to G him up a wee bit and say, come on, you know what I mean? We're all here, you know we are. And try to G him up, but the fighting spirit was always there. He fought it all the way. He really was brave.
It's a shame, no, because obviously at the end of the day, I mean, even he was asking them, just use me. There was drugs out there. Just use me as a guinea pig. I'll take it, try it, just to see.
There's a lot of things that's happening out there in the scientific world, you know, that a lot of people, you know, if they take a closer look at it, you know, especially in the stem cell research, which the big guy just last week there died, who was a great campaigner for it. And the truth's there, you know, I'm almost certain. And as we say, they've came leaps and bounds in it. And I just want people to realise this, and to take it on board, not just for this, but for every neurodegenerative illness that's out there. And surely, God, that's worthwhile. If you're thinking about millions and millions upon people's lives, surely you've got to look at it seriously.
Came back to Celtic, when Jock came back to Celtic, I thought Hampden was our training ground. We were there that often, my car when they go by Mount Vernon, or Mount Florida, whatever it was, wherever it says Mount, I would go off and thought it was that going to training.
Cos Celtic a lapa for Castan an trifiche sa seach go bunia ti chwyl y dŵr sy'n fydd chorym. Hyd i gynnwyd y benymel yn y nechtri iddo chwyd gael a ffichyd gen i chiechen, ach fe chynki i ffaddach gyn nach dychlychia chymma sy'n yn y Lisbon.
To be honest, I didn't feel as if that was the one of my better games. You were there, you contributed some, but I believe that the players that were the defenders and the midfielders, because they made it all happen.
I think the European Cup final, Jimmy, myself, Stevie, Wisp, we didn't go on the ball a lot, but the midfield boys and the back boys were on it a lot, so you just do your job. Jimmy maybe wasn't on the ball very much, but I'll tell you what, he made space for everybody else.
And Johnson! Wingsley by Snarky, great effort by Johnson. Over Campolini. A penalty, he's getting it, it's a penalty. It's 1-0 for Inter. Oh, great shot, a wonderful save. Great shot by number 3, Kimmel. Kimmel, he's scored a great goal! He's done it!
Lee Jinky was brilliant in European ties because we could get the ball at his feet and he would go and run at defenders and open up the defence and make openings for the other forwards.
Murdoch! It's there! Celtic has scored!
There's lots of medals out there, but there's only one European Cup medal, and I think some of the games in that run that Celtic had in the European Cup, Jimmy was immense. He was immense. I mean, it was a great team, you know? I think Jimmy would look at that himself and say, well, that was great to get a European medal.
Bethynia Jeffrich of the Jimmy issue of Portugal. Vina Adenish, Svats Vassel to Yakuna Boy and the Lisbon, Vasuya Hugater Yalich, a Gaknes, at Asha Glasgow.
I had Miri that week and not a visitor. I'm sitting, Celtic could win the cup. I had all these brothers and everything. And the next thing I hear all this noise and all my brothers were drunk, getting this motor down, a big motor down the road, and they're running after all the nurses and hurling all the veins about. My blood pressure was sky high with a lot of them.
That was my visitors. I was embarrassed that day, sitting with myself in this bed. No, a visitor, next thing, they came in and caused all this commotion.
I was firstborn child, so I was born in May, the 21st, 67. So the other two siblings nicknamed me the golden child, if you like. So born a few days before we won the European Cup, or Celtic won the European Cup, I should say. So daddy's girl and a typical Johnston, as my mum would say.
No, I never watched the game. I never saw it. I was nearly bothering. Like after you've had a win and that's you, isn't it?
My family, you know, they have stuck by me and I owe them everything. When there is always something there to remind me. Always something there to remind me.
Always something there to remind me. Mara Hennig, MND, you grey Maravchuk, that Jimmy you find Kurum Nagachi.
My mum was a sole carer and she really had to do a lot, everything herself for my dad, and it was heavy work for her, you know. But she managed it. My mum, just my mum. She gets on with it. That's what she does, you know.
I'm not like him then, and you see not on her. No, she was doing it, but then we'd laugh and all. My mum used to come in at night for the club. Like, she goes every weekend, right, to the club. And they used to be on this stair lift, and see when it got to the top, there's a wee kind of sharp bend. She used to turn and his knees would hit everywhere, and I used to hear him screaming at the top of us. And he used to shout on me, James, she's trying to day me in.
I mean, one day we better come in, you know that brown leather, the brown leather for support for, you've got arthritis and that. And Bertie came in, we brought her, maybe if you put this on. So we put it on him, we couldn't get it back off. And see the laugh we had that day. He's sitting and Bertie's trying to pull it and I'm trying to pull it. So the laugh we had that day. But I mean, it was just, you got a laugh with it, with things they used to talk about and everything. So they did.
I used to go and see him on a regular basis. And it was quite amazing, his spirit, at that time, was just as big as the spirit he'd had through his life when he was playing, when people were kicking lumps out of him. He had this huge strength to battle against this brutal illness. It was difficult. And I remember saying to his wife, I'm finding it difficult, Agnes. She says, I know, but she says, he likes to patter. He likes to patter, Willie. And, well, it's difficult.
Better in tell you less of you read the Chumas Glossit, opposite Jack Jim Simonetti is asked Jalasach, as to your ear does the Willie Hockey.
By the time Willie had phoned me back, within an hour, I was sitting outside Jimmy's house waiting to go in. I was that excited to go and meet him and look and see what this meant to look after him.
We had to change the whole room downstairs so that Jimmy could basically live in that room, building a shower at the back, making it flat so he could get about.
Va marker on a ballach and a tune of a stay with Bear Jimmy.
Tony Judt, the famous historian, had motor neuron, and he described what I think Jimmy was feeling. He said, when you have motor neuron, you're in a solitary, confined cell. And the walls are coming in inch by inch every day. And that evoked the image every time I saw Jimmy at that stage.
A spirit Jimmy just about Eve.
No, he was always a battler, you know, he was always chirpy. Any time I seen him, even with illness, he was always wanting to laugh and wanting to be chirpy and happy. He was never down.
It was just an amazing demonstration of how to cope with an illness. He was fantastic at that particular time. And, you know, I think we're all very proud of him.
Van Jiddishach show the Vienna Jimmy the Who's. Fuse Navalach Og, Ruprichek a Cruise and Fine Haddish of Isfian.
Jimmy had all glass bottles in the flare. He go out and he'd run, run about. That's just your own time in the morning. And he never stopped, never stopped.
I used to go to the old, which was across from my mother's, the old Thornwood Park. It was Thornwood Junior's. There was a rail right round about the park. And I used to go up on it and walk it.
He used to go on my shoulders and I punted him up, you know, for balance. He used to walk in this wavy fence. So that was, I came in handy for that, for my height. So it was on my shoulders and punted him up. And he walked, he'd done that for ages. This is after training as well, and we knew that this was part of his job as well, but take us up to see our gran. But while we were visiting my gran, he'd be jumping over and doing his bit of training over in Thornwood.
Ach, fa cwys yn jyffri sy'n sy'n sgol gyda, thar a roedd rad big o yen o gof a sy'n sy'n sgol.
When you were sitting at lesson and somebody would come in with a note, and it was Johnson, blah, blah, you should go to Mr. Cringy's room and that was you for an hour. And he was going through the tactic or what, no, you know, about the game before it or the game you were going to play.
Jimmy, I would compare him to a boxer, shadow boxing. His imagination was going at 100 miles an hour. He was imagining there was a defender there. He was imagining he needed to body swerve. He was practicing the body swerve. He was imagining this. He was imagining everything that could possibly happen. He would imagine he was playing for Celtic at that point, because that was his dream team. He was imagining he was playing for Scotland.
My dad, Matt, as I said, he was a miner, you know, in Moore's Pit at the time. And I got his boots, pit boots, and I used to take that into my training schedule as well. I would go for 20 minutes or something, and see when you took them off, you know, you could have jumped to the crossbar.
Eileen sort of reigned in my parade, I must say. She was born 11 months after me, so I didn't even get a full year. She's the second of me, 68, and I'm the 21st, 67, so she did arrive a wee bit early.
I'm the youngest in the family. I've got two older sisters who kind of looked after me a bit, so I'm like the youngest one at the mall.
At sy'n fath y ffas ywys, bydd chi'n yn sgapau bwyn i fe sydd efo chysiorbwch y chi'n yn llynion.
When you've been playing European games, and he'd always have a doll for me and my sister. My brother wasn't born at the time, but I remember him coming back maybe the middle of the night, and Mum getting us up, Dad's back, you know. He'd come in and he'd always have two dolls for me and my sister, and he'd put one behind his back, and he'd to pick a doll each.
A cawn yn jiwl i charaŵn ag ac yn ysyson gemachan, ach fa'n cael jyst edrych i hens Jimmy Cwach ych ysmaranach.
Just put up with him. I know I felt like strangling her shooting him one of the times, but I still just put up with him and that was it. And then there he ended up in life, you know what I mean? Good job we'd be about to look after him, wouldn't it?
He and his wife were the greatest double act I've ever come across. Even at the height of his illness, the jokes they cracked with each other, it was a self-sustaining rescue act from the misery they could have gone into had they just surrendered to the inevitable, and they didn't.
Jimmy loved his family. Agnes, need to do this for Agnes, this Agnes, as long as Agnes is okay. Jimmy's biggest concern going through the last part of his illness was that Agnes was going to be okay.
His family were amazing. I mean, especially Agnes, you know, had to put up with him all her life, you know. I don't know, she's certainly there's an angel on earth.
He was talking about stem cells. Like, man, when I get these stem cells, we'll be out and we'll get a bit heavy, and you know. So we're going out the door and Agnes says, hey, you two. Yes, Agnes. Let me tell you this. See if these stem cells work. She said, yes, Agnes. She said, I'll kill the wee bastard myself.
We'll be right back. Unth of Smoonian and Ahadovic Jimmy Johnson at Celtic. Mu Chichtlin lead, Coed Cuthbun a Halapa, Keir Cuthbun lead, Agus Cuthbun a Helper. Bad Mullach a Hawash. Ach van Solas Shun of the Vunchug, Lisha Vua Yuk Joch Larcheder, Fashkit Jidder, the Lion Plucher.
He'd maybe smell it off him, but he wouldn't. No, I wouldn't say anything bad about him. You know, Jimmy was Jimmy. And I think people with exceptional talent sometimes can be a wee bit off the rails in their behaviour in life.
He added substantially to the gaiety of nations off the field too, didn't he?
It's on Grush, that Jinky is Moonin Kirachiaki, the Joch of Humal for Smach, Achmen and Ven, Sanahu the Boch, the Smach Kiddison.
Listen, let's be honest. We played hard, I mean, we worked hard, but at the weekend, we done a bit, and he gave us a head to do that. You know, Saturday, Sundays, that was your days. And, you know, we swallowed a few, you know, swallowed a wee bit and that, but that's par for the course. As soon as Monday hit, we were doing maybe twice a day, just to make sure that we were ready for the Saturday again. And we proved it with the success we had. We never cheat at M Day.
Megedig Howell, who's Jock Steen, got a Jimmy Ulug at Celtic. Stoch a gerry ur, bevound the horse go heel, a sanachaya vua ye bullach.
The worst thing it was leaving here. I remember breaking my heart out there in the car park when you knew they weren't coming back in the door again. It was one of the secretary, Irene, she said, right here, and it was like your books, you know, and I was like, ah. You know, and because it's all your life, and you know, it was so much had happened, and it was hard.
Only time I ever seen him running out of the place and crying.
That was the end of the world. That was, well, I couldn't believe he'd been let go, you know. It was a shame, but the gaffer just said, "What's that's it, Jimmy, you know, we need to go." Shame.
Dat de pudding en chill lach je en wat gegaaid dat alles je vroeg.
It just been done till after that. When my dad left Celtic, I think part of him left himself. I think the only team he wanted to play for was Celtic. The only team he ever played for was Celtic, even though he did go here and there and everywhere. It was, I felt, you know, the heart was gone then. It wasn't the same as it was. Could anything ever be the same as that? I think it broke him a bit, you know, and he went down, like, you know, kind of dark roads, and it was sad, it really was. He wasn't the man that we knew when he was drinking, you know, because he was a fantastic dad, you know, he really was. He'd lived for his grandkids as well, you know, but great man. He was sober when he was sober, he was great, you know, but you could tell he was sad when he started drinking.
Oh, it's heartbreaking to watch somebody that you love, and no matter, you know he loves you and you know there's a good person in there, but no matter how hard he tries, the drunk sort of at that time always wins.
Hated it. Torture. So it was. Absolutely. Even now when I think back, I'm breathing in because you're like, destroyed you. No, because you used to be like, oh my God. No, going for maybe 2-3 weeks, little in a bender. No, that was, and then he'd come off it for a couple of months, then bitching again to go for it again, and then he'd be away, and he used to lock the doors, he'd be climbing out of the windows to get away, and soul destroying sometimes. Wherever I go, there's
a shadow. Hiach Jimmy, the Toshach Toshach Yuri, and another Glosha Haynes and Chowlach in America, a clichus on San Jose earthquakes, a Charochlius Granch.
Fantastic America was, yeah. My sister even got an American accent when we were there. So she did.
America, which was like, to be honest, for us at the time, was like, you know, we went on holiday, to be honest. Didn't really last that long there. But my dad was a home bird. He could never be away from here, View Park, for very long. The, you know, the people, family. and he never settled there.
That was a different, it was a novelty. The San Jose earthquakes, but it was all razzmatazz and I couldn't get away, I couldn't fall into that pattern, but going onto the park one at a time and all the majorettes and all giving you the rah-rah-rah bit and all that, you know, and all these guys, they were all hyped up, the American style football before you went out. I used to look at them and say to these, what is it they're doing? You know, they used to get them, come on, you know, let's go and that, all that. Oh, I just went through the motions there as well.
Hi, Jimmy and Ocean go Sheffield United's call of the share noon train at Glasgow, but John McGeady, who had Mishnich, Majedig Howell, Breen, the Lou Hawke.
I said, are you signing for one of the Sheffield clubs? He says, I'm signing for Sheffield United. I said, I'm an apprentice with Sheffield United. He said, why did you not come through and talk to me? I'm sitting in that carriage all the way down myself. I don't know. I was just so shy.
Get the hochgrich at Grishan in Sheffield, how do I find you doors, Ravada Shabanager, shelf week at the Celtic, Jimmy Cyril.
I don't think him and Jimmy had it off, really, because Jimmy Cyril had a strange way of dealing with football players. He used to speak in riddles.
I just got into a way that it was nae, it just was nothing, you know, really. Unfair maybe to Jimmy Cyril and that, who was the manager who brought me down there at the time.
Even though Jimmy Cyril was desperate to get Jimmy to Sheffield United, from my perspective, I think in many ways he blamed Jimmy for the demise of the first team, and I thought it was incredibly unfair.
Ach, but Jimmy has the goal to traum, agus y mianach ag y call of the Shechuchuch gyfag ag Ian Snishaw Lyon ag Celtic.
Well, it must be people that was with him all his life, especially the Celtic people, you know, and as you say, the manager, Jock Steen, and Sean Fallon, Neely, and all of them, Bob Rooney. He'd miss all these people, you know. People that maybe could put an arm around the shoulder and say, Jimmy, this is the right direction and that's the wrong direction, you know.
It kind of went off the rails. And but I was fortunate I didn't see that. I didn't want to see it.
Iachach Jimmy ddig ddiach gwych ala ddiach chag Shelburne as Elgin City a charo am nach tullich tamalch. Ronishin, chai a conla ddi hewn charis Tommy Gemmel, y fan a fanager at Dundee.
I actually phoned him and said, are you interested in coming to Dundee? And he said, aye, big man. Certainly big man. No problem, big man. Because it's no use here. I'm past it here.
Whom Jimmy had a goal like Dundee to have the chluchach tí gemachan. Now, you ishan, who like a manager bailish ka pick in and chown Jimmy so no one you gather to vag dens.
I took him in to do a job. And that was to take on defenders. And he could do that. He could take on defenders like that, go past them and make openings for the other players. To a certain extent, he did the job well.
I can tell by your eyes that you've probably been...
Le nádar a bheith a blá, bheith fyrstu de Jimmy Carriage in a hwgal, sfa cwch na sanyamil yn a fyw anile.
I said, Marie, that's the big man for the crucifixion. And it was Billy Connolly, because he'd done the crucifixion album at the time. And he was crawling along the bedroom floor, and he'd get Andy Neely between us. So he said, and we started talking, just chatting away till we got up for school, and then fell asleep in our bed. That's what he did. But it was just extraordinary sometimes.
If Healy acted Jimmy on the View Park, Charamaloch and Fatatus Corley to Rod Stewart, Manchlar Urake.
As Willie Hawkes phoned me, he says, Rod Stewart's going to pop out with bright shock when he came in. But he had a good blather, and Rod was there with his brothers and that night. So he had a kid in the morning about his music, never, you know. That was when he was doing the kind of Frank Sinatra numbers, and he was telling him he was rotten at them. He says, I prefer you doing your all-time numbers and all that. I says, redneck here.
Ach ar ôl chwlydyn yn ag harajan dy Jimmy Johnson gyda. An y Montevideo chai ychydig a cocol o chdiau y ffaithgy. Agus chai mwy y gyda fe, grŵn hwrsyn.
So I was in the hotel, and we got a phone call, me and Bobby, about 1 o'clock in the morning. And obviously, I mean, you're in your room, so it's got to come through the switchboard. And the voice, is it John, you know, and I says, uh-huh. And Bobby lifted it and he says, it's for you. I was like, I'm wondering who'd be in at that time in the morning, you know. For once we were in my rooms.
And he said, I said, aha. He said, you're dead. And I went, bumped the phone, went, you know, dead. The phone went. And I was like, he said, who was it? I said, I don't know. I said, somebody says that they're going to kill me. And he went, you're kidding? I said, no. What have I done? Sounds my luck in. I don't even know any of them.
They said they were going to kill wee Jimmy, you know, they were going to do him in. So I went into the room, and the first thing I did was drew the curtains, and that was the room shut the whole time we were there. Then lifted an apple off the fruit bowl, went to bed, and I said, what are you doing? I think I'm getting him with an apple, you know. I said, no, wait a minute. The dentist were going to shoot you, the dentist were going to throw something, maybe they poisoned the fruit. So that was the fruit back in the bowl and he was walking about. It was really, really funny.
So he took me to the side, he says, after a couple of days, he says, listen, he says, I don't want to worry, he says, but for a threat. He says, they're going to shoot me and you, I went off.
He wasn't for playing. Big joking him, oh, you're going out there. He says, no, me.
When he says, what chance have they got? He says, he hitting you. He says, once you get onto the park, he says, and you're doing your duty and jack, there's no chance of hitting you. He says, I'm sitting in that dugout.
That's right. That's right. Now, Shach gets a Jimmy Ulu, Marklik at the Balkasha, Svan Graim, a Vekin Jochid, at the Vair, a Gisbear Howlett, you could put us kiln.
I'll speak as an alcoholic, you know what you're doing. You swear you're going to, and Jimmy was the same, I'm going to get better. I know what I'm doing. But the minute you took that first drink, majority alcoholics are the same. All bets are off, as they say, you're off and running again. And the guilt builds up again. The hellish feeling, you think you're better out the way, you're useless. Agnes and the family went through a terrible time, and I don't mean that in a bad way, but they were always there for them.
The things I put Agnes through, and my kids, you know, Marie, Eileen and James, that I put through, I'm not proud of. And it hurts me to think all the things that I did to them. But it wasn't me. Really, to be honest, and that isn't me. It's where it takes you, the way it affected you. You're a different person than the girl. I know the people that have went through the traumas of then drinking, went in it and come out of it, will tell you just where it takes you. It takes you to the gutter.
Gyn chosnigs gawgan yn anafiachan fe Jimmy is Agnes yn ymwys y dach i chawl. Na eigin, sy'n edrych y dygolaga, hiach adys na bwyn ac yr eich, cogynwg y garych i gyfer.
I never ever knew he was going to sell those because they were up in the loft. And I was, next thing a car came that day and went away out with them.
And he came in and just plunked this in my table and says, here's my medals, give me 10 grand. And it was sad, it was a kind of sad moment. And although it was 9 o'clock, I think he'd started. And, you know, I think he'd had a liquid breakfast. And I said to him, no, I'm not giving you 10 grand. I says, I'm not buying your medals. He's got people and he says, right, this is what we're going to do. And he's planned, he's mapped it out, and it's worked. And the problems are in their way, but God, it's a hell of a lot better than they were this time last year. I said to him, here's what we're going to do. You know, I'll take care of this, whatever you need done, and I will hold your medals in trust, you know, and for the family and what have you. And we'll get your problems sorted out, but you'll not be selling your medals.
Lei opeth hiendrach rein Jimmy y gi chael ffyddoch sombra. Ach chiddach yn yr fa ffain siach at y ddyntra plaj chai toloch as yn siol ych i filig lys yn neach mewn chinius motor neuron. Fa'n cael eithaf Jimmy y Celtic VSG eich geilwch taich. Sfa mis sor eich jac iddyn nhw yn y fwy cryniach chi sy'n chewn chi'n gen y ffaith ys yn canagat yn jungle.
But God, what a lift it gave us. Oh, that place, honestly, well, I think the boys will all agree with you as well. That's where you played to that. They deserved it. They paid their money. And you were an entertainer, really. At the end of the day, that was your stage. And they deserved it. A wee bit special, a wee bit extra. When I get the ball, I could feel them starting to... Then he used to go on the back of my neck and say, well, let's go. Just keep a hold of it for a couple of minutes. And then
as the boys says, you know, as Bobby would say, it just gives it back when you're finished. When you go at that and you got that feeling, the buzz going through the place, it's tremendous.
Fágal Celtic go cíolach go raibh chud cúl leis rud a bheith a fiprach an mian cos an blúch taith go hálach s céim a chud na gcásan. Bhidís sin a chdia sa tuad a dhíobh seachata.
He was a wee bit scared. I'm not too sure. You know, he didn't really talk much about it. But I think he was scared that he would stop walking. I think that's what he was scared, in case his legs wouldn't take him anymore.
I came home from it and I sat with him, massaged his hands and his feet and spoke to him, gave him his green tea. So he wouldn't drink any other tea, so it was this, and we had a straw and a caramel wafer biscuit.
Grandkids kept him going. They just run in and kiss him in the head, and they knew because he couldn't cuddle them and everything then. They were his life. The kids just kept him going, all the grandkids. He loved them, he lived for them.
But Bertie Auld, the Ferrilla of Atuna Nachul Taika.
Bertie was never away from him. Kept his spirits going a wee bit and do anything for him, you know. And they got to respect that, you know. And you hear about people, good things like that deserve credit a wee bit, you know.
Betty was sensational with him. I mean, I don't think there was a day when Betty wasn't there and keep me spirits up.
Bán báthal ag Jimmy, the MND, na bhros na chúis an cíne le chúr, smar chóraith bé Jimmy Johnson, chrúig sér a Fabergé nui tíu cien a huyen animal. Amas a chóra dis a djeolach.
Just came out the blue, and it was unbelievable because it was just this Fabergé egg, is it? Like, you don't think, you know, like, is anybody would get one designed after it, especially not your dad, you know? It was unbelievable, it's beautiful as well. You realise it's stunning, but it was just amazing. You couldn't believe it yourself, I don't think. It was a great thing to see. And I'm so proud of that.
Doing an Irishal ring, Jimmy Keenyuch got on your hoochichead and Lea Suez, Ula and Lahad, and now you can't get any more, but you can't get the better idea of Celtic.
He gave me 50 tickets a year. Give it already him says, I go there. Make sure they get them now. Don't you be selling them for drink. Make sure they get them. But when he came in that day, he seen them. That was when he got his presentation. Here we were sitting up there. Oh, the big posses, right? Oh, that'll do me. I carry on, Jimmy.
That night and everyone that represented, and you know that in his heart, that was him. He was like, that's me. I suppose that was one of the best nights of his life.
Well, Celtic's greatest ever player, Mr. Jimmy Johnson!
I get the honour of the greatest Celt, you know, so. And you see the statue out there, it's typical with a bit of the head down and that, you know.
View Park as well. Everywhere I go, I'm bumping into him. So
no getting away from him.
Can't you get away from him? Yeah.
Gehanasach that Jimmy Kujach Kirchin got a coikrich acquired for Plana Janela.
Jimmy had a thing about UFOs, which, and there was no talking to him about it, absolutely none.
He'd phone you up and say, "Wee man," called me "wee man" all the time, you know. And he says, "There's a program on, say, just 141 or something like that. It's all about aliens, you know." And I had to stop what I was learning, because I had to go through it bit by bit with him, you know. He loved anything about the aliens, you know. And he phoned up and he says, "Wee man, you fancy taking me up in the car and we'll set up at Cumbernauld, and we'll maybe from about 12 o'clock to about 2 o'clock. I says, "Man," I said, "Jimmy, could you picture us two up there, eh? Sitting there in a wrap at the window, what would happen, eh?"
Mae'r achais lawnt i Jimmy i mesod i as yn cart ys di hewlwch nes lawnt iddo, a chy gan yn ychwyl i dylai ys fe gad y dyn yn sydachu.
We got a wee bit pally then. So we did, but I was giving him the cheek then, you know what I mean? It was me, it was getting tough then. So I was sit there and do what I'm telling you now, eh? So I used to say that to him. He says, "You're getting your rain back in me, big one, ain't you?" I says, "Aye, I'm getting my rain back in you now. Sit there and do what I tell you."
I think in those 5 years, we became closer than we had ever been, I think, as a family. It does, things like that, do that to a family. And you wonder where you get, you know, the kind of strength to... I don't know where my mum and my dad got it from to keep going, you know, but he did, and he fought it. All the way.
We fought so very close as a family, really, really close. The house was always full of the kids, us. There was never none of us, every day there was always one of us here. If we were all here together. My mum's like, "Oh no, they're back again." But really did, we really did get strong as a family then. We did, we were all really there, supportive for each other.
Loved it. Loved the times that we had in that wee room next door. Used to watch the Celtic and Rangers games. And he used to sit there and I'd be Celtic school. I used to jump up, now the adrenaline going through you and be like, "Oh my God, what you did!" The fright he gave me, no, but aye, that was the kind of, I know it's sad to say, but in his last years were the kind of best years for us, no, as we go kind of closer.
Savarch, Davila Sashia, Coig Blearness, Jurig and Chinus Nochig, Hoshik Jimmy Johnston is fast lack, Agasuki Hulloch, Gravage and Cacown.
I was going away a weekend to my pal's caravan and I can remember telling him that I loved him. And I kind of shook his head and he was like, nearly took the head off my shoulders there kind of thing, no. But it was about that at the end, so it was.
I'd been here on the Friday and he'd started to lose his voice on the Friday and I'd say to him, you're all right, because he'd been able to speak up to this. And he says, "No, I'm just fed up." So obviously, God, I'm sure I said, "No, it doesn't seem right this today." He was really, really down that day. And so obviously all weekend on the phone, he's just, I'm fine.
I stayed obviously on the Saturday to the late evening, but all the family had been down and it was like, Cheerios, I think, you know, and looking at him, it was like he's, I think when his voice went, he kind of, he lost, you know, a lot of kind of even more fright, to be honest.
That day he couldn't get out of bed, so he just stayed in bed and he ate his tea and you'd always to watch what you were getting to eat.
This time his throat was closing down, he was in bed and he was very frail.
Hidden Dara Lachi again of Arsh, Hai Aknus can lepi, Jish Elkis, Jimmy Achuchu, Marasash, the show on the Ichima Yedder give a gaka conway.
I had him up earlier in the morning, I had him up twice. And then, you know, the way I woke up and I thought, he's no woke me for a couple of hours. And I turned around and he was just passing away in his sleep.
Seems like it was yesterday when I saw your face.
In Ala, in Tresla, Giok, in Avarsh, Yeg, James Connolly Johnson. Harawach, Tifikit Sahun.
When the news came in the Monday morning, although it's still a shock to hear the words, I wasn't, you know, that surprised that it had happened because I thought, you know, it was kind of saying cheerio over the weekend.
Mum phoned me. It was 6 o'clock on the Monday morning. They'd passed away through his sleep. And luckily my mum was beside him when that happened.
To be honest, yeah, he'd fought as hard as he could. He was at a point where the quality of life, I don't think, was there anymore. So, one of those things. But my mum was with him, so... it's hard.
You know, it's a bit of a shock, but it's the only way it's a shock when you're phoning people and, you know, the only way you're getting... I mean, I had to phone my brother to come down so as I could phone Bertie and I'd phone the doctor and all that, you know what I mean?
And the phone rings and Aggie says to me, Jimmy's passed away. Very difficult, you know.
Bertie just went off the phone. He just left his phone hanging. He couldn't put his phone back on. He was shocked.
I would hold you in my arms. I would take the pain away. Thank you for all you've done. Forgive all your mistakes. There's nothing I wouldn't do to hear your voice again. Sometimes I want to call you, but I know you won't be there.
It's like playing out, I think, in your mind. You know, it's like a film as if you're watching it. You know, you're like hoping it's not happening, but it is happening. But things just keep, you know, it has to trundle on, it has to keep going.
Hi, and you're on cheer like you, Jimmy, a human safari shake a hain. So no, Nicholish, for the force of hain is Agnes.
He never lost his roots, but he had a gem of a wife in Agnes. Now, I mean, Agnes was a real power of strength for him. Mind you, she brought him down to earth whenever it was needed. I know that it happened that often, Agnes, eh?
Coming out of the chapel was uncanny. It was Nuddingston and... I promise you. I see this... to this day. The players was carrying him out and as the doors was open, the sun came. The sun came out and shone right down in the chapel, down the stairs as we were walking.
Even the wee school, the school that he always went to, they were all out as well, and they were passing by, all the kids. So they were, it was nice, that was.
Best thing I've ever seen was at Celtic Park. That was one of the best experiences ever. And I knew, deep down, that he'd have loved it, no? That was, but all the fans, I can remember it. Beautiful.
So proud, couldn't believe it, because you didn't realise how much these people loved them, you know. Turning that corner, it was just unbelievable. It was.
Aye, that was a hard day, yeah. Aye, we all took that pretty hard.
Jimmy wanted the kids to play on in his name, and we waited until 2009 to set up his academy. And since 2009, there's 16 players progressed from there into professional football. You know, and he said 22 players from different nationalities playing within his academy as well. So that again is a magnificent story for him, and he would love that.
How do you sum a man like that up? An amazing character.
An amazing man. Just my dad.
family we had, well, the hillbillies. So we were. But anyway, we were all happy, and that was it.
As long as there's an alien program on the television, I'll never forget him, you know.
He went to chapel more often than I did. I think he had to write enough for forgiveness.
What do you miss most about him?
Himself. Just his presence.
I think all the boys miss him.
Just his wee face. Miss the way he was with the kids, because he would have been so proud of them all. You know, they've turned into great adults, all of them. Every time I come in, I look in there, talking to him. I play videos on YouTube and things just to hear his voice.
I wrote my letter and put it in the coffin for him, telling him that he's my hero. Huh?